Saturday night in Sydney, Ahmad Elrich's divine intervention spared Socceroo blushes against an inexperienced Iraq outfit. Tonight, the Australians face another Asian opponent in Indonesia, as they did 32 years ago. Then, the Socceroos inflicted 3-1 and 6-0 drubbings on their closest geographical neighbour in World Cup qualifying, a campaign that was ultimately successful. The hope is the path will again lead to Germany and a second appearance in the World Cup finals. But the 92nd-ranked Indonesians come into this clash after finishing runner-up in the recent Tiger Cup. So Peter Witt's men should provide stern opposition. It's Australia versus Indonesia, coming to you exclusively live from Subiaco Oval in Perth.
Yes, we're in the Western Australian capital for the first time since 1995, following the Socceroos. The Wacca Ground was the venue that night in June, and the visiting Ghanaians were 1-0 victors. The crowd that's turned up tonight will be hoping for a better result. Good evening to you. Welcome again to the World Game and the second clash in 4 days for the Australians in this Power 8 series. Tonight, Indonesia is the Socceroos opponent in another historic game where all net proceeds go to the FIFA Tsunami Relief Appeal. Tragically, Indonesia suffered another serious earthquake early today, and naturally the hearts of the Australian people go out to the victims and their families. To briefly preview the clash, I'm joined now by former Socceroo Craig Foster. Craig, nice to see you.
Nice.
Craig, the big story, and we'll get to the details later with Simon Hill, that Frank Farina has made 8 changes from the team that played Iraq on Saturday.
Absolutely. Predictably, he always said that he had a large squad, 25. Of course, Paul Agostino has gone for family reasons. 24 left. He was going to give everyone a run. So it's an opportunity for him and for us to take a look at John McKain starting in midfield today. Also, Luke Wilkshire gets a run. Sterjovski will start a match as well. Ante Milicic. So a lot of players there with something to prove, an opportunity to do so tonight.
And big guns like Cahill and Bresciano on the bench. I gather if Australia gets into some kind of strife, they can always come on.
Absolutely. They may get a run in the second half. They may get some time, just depending on how the guys go. But I think it's important for Frank that he does use everyone who's come into camp. You know, guys like Ante Milicic, it's a good opportunity for him. Luke Wilkshire, he wants to have a look at him. Johnny McKain came on in midfield the other night. I thought he looked the part. So it's a big opportunity for him again tonight. And of course, the big story for us is Ljubo Milicevic, former Ouliaris captain, who is starting in the centre of defence. He's had awful injury problems in the last couple of years. He now gets his opportunity.
And a big opportunity for the fans here in Perth. It's a rare appearance for the Socceroos. I think we might expect a lot more of this if Australia does indeed join the Asian Football Confederation, because this is a beautiful time zone for the Asian markets. And I guess it'll be tempting for some more games to be played here in Perth. And the Indonesians, of course, are opponents of Australia quite a number of times, 5 times down the years. They're not easy beats, no. Craig. We have lost to them once, in
Absolutely.
Fact.
Absolutely. 4 wins and 1 loss is the record. But Peter Wythe is the technical director and the coach at the moment, and he's, of course, a double winning of the Tiger Cup with Thailand. So he will have them very, very well organised, instilled a new sense of confidence into this Indonesian side.
Well, from what I remember of the Indonesian teams that I've seen in the past, Craig, and you may not have been around when I saw those, but they're very skillful on the ball, very good in technique, but probably a little bit easy to intimidate. But if they overcome that, they can be a great force in football, I believe.
Well, there certainly is 250 million residents over there, and football is enormous. We saw one of the legs of the Tiger Cup final. There was 100,000 fans over in Indonesia. It's huge in that country. They're very strong in midfield tonight. Panaro, the skipper, is a good player. Bahri is the ball winner up front. Ilham is a good player as well. They have a good man between the sticks, Kartiko. He's been around for a number of years with Indonesia, and in fact he's the only Indonesian ever to be selected in the AFC Team of the Year. So quite a keeper, and I would expect him to be fairly busy tonight. Defensively, they're not terribly strong, so it should be a fairly stirring performance from the Socceroos tonight.
Well, it's an important match in terms of international football diplomacy, which is why we're seeing the chairman of Football Federation Australia along with the president of the AFC, Mohammed bin Hammam, and Frank Lowy there, of course, shaking hands with the players. It's been a historic week for Australian football, and I guess there'll be much more of this in the future.
It's very much something for us to look forward to, something we haven't seen for years. You know, dignitaries from the AFC over here in Australia. Of course, you saw some smiling faces there from the Indonesian players. Les, they've shown enormous heart, enormous courage to be playing this evening. We know a couple of the players in the squad are from the affected region this morning, so it's quite incredible that they can not only come out to play, but do so with a smile on their faces. And as you said at the start, you know, our hearts really do go out to all Indonesians back home, but obviously to these players with the courage to play tonight.
The green and gold army out in force on the terraces, and you saw some of the names on the back of the Australian shirt, so you'll know some of the players that are coming in. In fact, one of them, Ljubo Milicevic, is making his debut. Now the crowd here at the stadium at Subiaco is being asked to respect the victims of the Boxing Day tsunami with a moment's silence. Chairmanship. A lot of things have already been made possible, Craig, and it's a good feeling, whatever happens tonight, to be able to engage with our Asian opponents in this way. Let's go to the national anthems, and then our commentator will be Simon Hill and Craig Foster.
Ya kebangsaanku, bangsa dan tanah airku, marilah kita berseru Indonesia bersatu.
Well, the words tragedy, disaster and catastrophe are overused in sport. The players and officials from Indonesia know only too well their proper meaning. Tonight they must try and play football while their nation grieves once again. Well, as a gesture of solidarity, the Australian team, which shows eight changes from the side that started against Iraq, have donated their match fees of $1,000 each towards the relief fund, plus $1,000 from any win bonus. So an Australian victory would swell that fund by around the $50,000 mark. Ljubo Milicevic makes his long-awaited debut in a much-criticised defence tonight, which also sees Tony Vidmar shifted to right-back. Further upfield, there are starts for John McKain, Luke Wilkshire and Jason Colina. Milos Sterjovski gets reward for his fine cameo on the wing on Saturday, and Ante Milicic leads the line. Goalkeeper Zeljko Kalac, incidentally, is selected in place of Mark Schwarter and wins his 50th cap. It's the usual 4-3-3 formation with Emerton and Sterjovski linking up with Milicic. Well, Indonesia are without three key players. Defender Yulianto, midfielder Eli Aboy, who had difficulties getting a visa out of Malaysia, and winger Boa Salosa, known as the Papuan Express, is actually sitting high school exams, so they're all absent. We'll bring you their team in a second. We just got a shot of the Australian captain there, Craig Moore, just waiting for his Indonesian equivalent. But the English coach, Peter Withe, for Indonesia, can still count on the craft of captain Pinaro in midfield. And up front, Ilham top-scored in the recent Tiger Cup campaign with 7 goals as Withe's side made the final. He's partnered by Firman, a fine prospect, but who lacks Boas Salosa's pace. It's a 3-5-2 formation. The two captains, Ponaro of Indonesia, who'll be wearing all white tonight, and Craig Moore. Australia will play in the yellow shirts, or the gold shirts, I should say, in the green shorts. Referee tonight is from Japan, Hirofumi Yamanishi, and his two referees' assistants are both from Australia. The fourth official is Mark Shue. Let's take in the toss. Little smiles. Seems as though Craig Moore has maybe won the toss. So whilst they sort out who's going to kick into which end, let's take a quick check on the substitutes. Plenty of quality, of course, so far as the Socceroos are concerned. A lot of big names, the likes of Mark Schwarzer and Lucas Neill. Tony Popovic, Marco Bresciano, Tim Cahill, who's been suffering a wee bit with the flu this week and is possibly a bit under the weather, so that's maybe why he's on the bench. Scott Chipperfield and John Aloisi, you know all the names by now. In terms of Indonesia, they've only travelled with a fairly small squad, just 18. Perhaps the surprise is that Kurniawan, the number 10, has been left on the bench. He actually played for 2 years in Switzerland with Lucerne and also had a trial with Sampdoria in Italy's Serie A, so we may see him a little bit later on. The officials, Matthew Cream and Jim Ouliaris, assisting the Japanese referee tonight, and confirmation that Mark Shield, Australia's most experienced referee, is the fourth official. It's a big night for Ljubo Milicevic, of course, tonight, back on familiar territory, 2 years with Perth Glory, after the last 12 months having been dogged by injury. There's Ilham for Indonesia, to say, top scored in the recent Tiger Cup with 7 goals, and that despite being suspended for part of that tournament. He's had a new lease of life under Peter Withe. The previous coach, Ivan Kolev, actually left him out of the Asian Cup squad last year, so he's got something to prove. We're all set to get underway at Subiaco Oval for the second game in this Powerade series. It's going to be Indonesia to get us underway, and incidentally, we'll be having our virtual spectator system in operation as well throughout the game. We'll be picking up the work rate of John McKain of Australia and Sulam Bakri of Indonesia. They both play in central midfield. Craig Foster and Les Murray will be analysing their work rate throughout the game. Here are Australia trying to launch the first attack of this international. Luke Wiltshire down the right-hand side. Support from Brett Emerton. Back there covering was Bakri. Expect him to get through a lot of work during this 90 minutes. He's very much in the engine room of the Indonesian midfield. Well, Craig Foster, Frank Farina said he wanted a 60% improvement in terms of the performance tonight.
Absolutely. The players, and obviously Frank Farina as well, somewhat disappointed in their performance against Iraq, because the result was a positive one. It's always better than not. These guys all have something to prove tonight. Certainly the likes of McKain, Milicevic, senior debut. Great to see him back after long-term injuries for the last 3 years.
Well, that's a careless pass by John McKain, and Indonesia are away here through Ilham. It's Ilham and a good stop by Kalac. And the follow-up, fortunately for the Socceroos, goes behind for a goal kick.
Just a repeat of the Iraq match the other night. First time they get into the half, they get through the Socceroo defence very, very early in the match. It was Ilham
He was able to break through. Sakaru defenders nowhere near him on that occasion. First strike wasn't bad. Zeljko Kalac did well, held his ground. Didn't go to ground too early. It's a fairly easy save in the end. Certainly early warning signs from the Indonesians.
Maybe a few nerves from John McKain. It is his first start for the Socceroos. No, it's not his first cap. Wilkshire draws the free kick. Playing in the midfield triumvirate, along with McKain and Jason Colina. Good to see Milicic Sterjovski get in the start as well. Very impressed with him against Iraq when he came off the bench. He and Ahmad Elrich gave a different dimension. All played through by Firman. Touch was by Bakri. Now Hortizan. Will play as one of the two wing-backs. Ismet is on the other side. And it's gone Australia's way. Crowd of around 20,000, I would say, inside the Subiaco Oval, the lovely city of Perth. Ticket sales were a little slow as Vidmar lost one into the box. Sterjovski was the target. Early play by Hendro.
Coming inside, Vidmar spied him. Just run across the line, getting behind what is an advancing Indonesian defence. We'll see that again from Sterjovski fairly soon.
It's a perfect night for football in Western Australia. Cool and clear. Pitch is in reasonably good nick. One or two bumpy patches, particularly in the centre. Has to play that other code of football here, I think, don't they, Craig?
I'm not too sure, to be honest. There's a few unfamiliar lines out there to me. One to count are the white ones.
Tony Vidmar's header. Now here's Wilkshire. Brett Emerton. It's good to see him get forward a lot more tonight than he did against Iraq. Against Sterjovski Target. Again, well played by Hendro.
That was a good run inside. Jason Culina also getting forward. This was just yards too long.
Flag's gone up, far side.
It's a late call. See that again. He's certainly playing off the shoulder of the Socceroo defenders, Ilham. Oh, he's looking to get in behind, no doubt. Peter Wythe has watched the tape of the other night, told us on the weekend, of course, that it would be of the Iraq match. I expect him to get very high on the shoulder of Moran Milicevic, try and get in behind.
Actually looks to me, Craig, as though Indonesia may be playing a 4-2-3-1 system with he'll come up on his own. More than that in a second. More work for Hendro. John McKay. Tony for his earlier out error.
Certainly expect Indonesia to play a point up front. That's no surprise. I expect them to go forward in numbers early in this match. Peter Wythe knows that'd be suicidal.
Lazaridis. Very familiar turf for him, of course. He's been quite vocal in saying that some stage in the future he'd like to come back and play in Western Australia. There's Peter Wythe, the Indonesian coach, two Tiger Cups with Thailand. Of course, he got to the final in 2004 when his team were beaten by Singapore. Craig Moore winning a header ahead of Ilhan. Ball's out of play. Let's quickly go down to the touchline with our sideline reporter, Andrew Orsati. Andrew.
Thank you, Simon, and good evening. I must say that the pitch gives a fair bit tonight. It's a little soft underfoot for what is a classic autumn evening. It was very warm in the day, but the temperature is dropping rapidly. And I don't think the players will have too many problems hearing themselves tonight because the atmosphere, despite it looking, I think, half full this stadium, it's very quiet out here.
Thank you, Andrew. Hopefully the Qantas Socceroos put a goal or two in the back of the net too. Lining the crowd up. Here's Brett Emerton trying to do just that. Ball is out, stuck to his man. Concedes the first corner of the game. It's gone Australia's way.
The ball over the top, trying to release Emerton. Noticeable Craig Moore bringing the ball forward there, trying to wave Tony Vidmar on. Numerical superiority in wide areas, the Australians. Need to bring the backs in.
Fancy forward for the set piece. Emerton towards the near post. It's Tony Vidmar coming through. He wants the corner too. He's scored one or two goals for the Socceroos down the years from set pieces, Craig.
He has. Just went over the head of Sterjovski there. as Vidmar came in. Saw him coming into the near post. Sterjovski's just got the slightest of headers.
Tell you what, he's got a point, but so it should have been a corner as well. That came off Walter's end for my money. Bermansar. Neill out wide right, picked up in midfield by Cornado. He's the man to watch out for Indonesia in the centre of the park. He is the playmaker. A couple of early touches for Ljubo Milicevic. Involved in this game on his senior debut.
It's good football. Goes out from the back very calmly. Three passes. Out.
Brett Emerton has also seen a lot of the ball in the opening minutes. Wilkshire trying to help it on.
Good effort by Wilkshire. Saw the run from Milicic. He heard the call before he received the ball. Just tried to help it on. Good move from the Australians going forward.
Second corner of the night. Both for Australia. Greener Gold Army behind the goal. Urge the national team on. Emerson's outswinger. There's the Blackburn Rovers number seven again. Sterjovski in space. Good effort too.
Well worth a go from there. Indonesians had a little bit too much space on the edge of the box. Ball comes inside from Emerton. It's a turn on the right. Sharpest strike with the left to the near post.
Just a slight delay before the third corner of the night is taken. Indonesia player, I think, just doing up his laces. He's stopped by the goalkeeper, known as the Indonesian Bartez. So make of that what you will. Come back out to Emerton. Wilkshire in support. Throw in Australia.
Interesting, Emerton very keen tonight to rip some early crosses in. Not too many the other evening. Be surprised if instructions are just that.
Here's Vidmar. Way too deep for Sterjovski. He was very quiet the other night, wasn't he, Brett Emerton? And he played sort of a more inside role than we normally see him play, both for Blackburn and the national team.
I think playing the 4-3-3, I'm pretty sure Frank Farina would have liked to see both Chipperfield and Emerton take up some more wide positions than they did. Inside a lot. Didn't provide any width. So we weren't getting the fullbacks forward. Didn't really get any crosses, taking advantage.
Awkward ball for Fermansar to deal with, but he did well. McKain then met it. Hamkar away. Now Craig Moore. Ante Milicic, good turn. Helped on its way towards Sterjovski. Oh, now that was a late challenge, no penalty, says the referee. And to Miller Sterjovski's credit, he didn't argue.
Well, hasn't appealed. Yeah, that's a very, very good decision from the referee there. Maybe a little bit cheeky from Sterjovski. Yeah, pretty easy. Good decision by the referee.
Now, Indonesia are desperately trying to get and wing back Ortizan back on the pitch. Peter Witt screaming at the referee. Down to 10 momentarily. In time, Colina to Emerton. Colina wants the ball played short. Steady goes towards Ante Milicic. The ball pass didn't quite come off for Australia. Here's Ismet. So that was Cunha one a little short. Here's Milicic joining in with the attack for Rolla. There's nobody up in support with him. It's Ljubo Milicevic into the side netting. Well, wouldn't that have been a dream debut?
Absolutely. What a good passage of play that is. Twice he's been on the ball. Once defensively and once offensively. And both times he's looked very, very comfortable. This occasion came forward, showed good composure. Played a couple of 1-2s, played into space. See a defender coming forward.
He's been earmarked for the national team for quite some time, hasn't he, Big Ljubo? Injuries have got in the way. Colina. Right to Sterjovski. Lazaridis in support. Brett Emerton was really was trying to pick out. It'll be an Indonesian goal kick.
And the idea is there to copy now from Tony Vidmar, so from Sterjovski, just slightly overhit. Milicic, slight height advantage. Emerton, likewise, wants to see them just dink one in around the 12-yard area.
Let's nip down to the touchline, and Andrew Orsati again. Andrew?
Simon, it appears Ilham is down receiving treatment for a cut to his head. It's a severe cut as well. He's bleeding profusely. And the forward official, Mark Shield, has told me now that it looks like the Indonesians are about to make a substitute. Peter Wythe has just called to the two players that he had warming up behind the Australian goal.
Thank you, Andrew. Particularly not so Peter Wythe needs at this moment in time. You can see the blood streaming down the neck of Ilham. Arguably, of course, has had the best chance of the game so far.
It's a real shame. And of course, is their real weapon up front. Rather nice to see. Convincing it like that.
Fuhrman was trying to get this better away on the left-hand side.
Recovering for Sterjovski.
Now Lazaridis. John McKay. Vidmar, Emerton, Indonesia have everybody back behind the ball. Rather reminiscent of Iraq at the weekend. Not quite sure they'll be able to attack us swiftly on the counter. It's very much as though Ilham is not going to be able to continue. See Kurnia wind down on the touchline waiting to come on. That might be his opportunity. Forced into this change of the night. I'm sure it's rather earlier than he would have liked too. He's made goal getter. Ilham has lasted just 11 or 12 minutes. Now this was the incident that led to that cut. It was the back of the head. Ljubo Milicevic. Moving with the elbow. Accidental clash. Kurniawan's not a bad replacement. A few Indonesians to play abroad in Europe. 2 years with FC Lucerne. Vidmar finding Emerton. Just kept in play.
Ball was just a bit too long for Brett there. It's a lovely cross-field ball by Jason Culina. Bring Vidmar into play.
Wilkshire was looking for the run of Tony Vidmar. Eventually got it. Tony Vidmar has done well to win the corner for the Socceroos. Vidmar will remain in the penalty area. Joined by Milicic and Craig Moore. Corner's been taken short though. Emerton tees it up for Jason Culina. A bit too intricate by the Socceroos. I would have thought, Craig, with superior height that Farina has at his disposal from set pieces, that have been trying to put pressure on the rather slighter Indonesians at the back.
Absolutely. I was just talking earlier about the crosses. So far, just out of range. Certainly have got a fancy Australia, should they just be able to get the ball into those right areas. Jason Culina there, surprised he didn't take a strike. Showed us the other night just how unselfish he is. A lovely dummy.
Ljubo Milicevic has given the ball away, actually his first error of the evening. Lazaridis nipped in. Tony Vidmar. Milicic has made the run down the channel. Top instead by Indonesia. First chance for Kurniawan to stretch his legs as the lone striker. Referee just putting out the correct place to take the throw. One Wiltshire. Now Brett Emerton. Sterjovski's made a steaming run down the middle. Well, he's played behind it. This man tidies up for Indonesia. Now Lazaridis. McKain. Again, a rather aimless ball for Brett Emerton. There's no doubting the Qantas Socceroos have had much more possession, Craig. Just really finding their feet a bit in this game.
Just some wayward passing. They'll be trying to force a few passes. Indonesians in wide areas doing well. They haven't had many opportunities to run at them with the ball.
This is a chance for the Indonesians maybe to counter. Bernardo. Cause problems given the space in midfield. Door quickly shut. Zeljko Kalac. Clears long upfield looking for Milicic. Ismet. Sterjovski for company. Kane to Moore. Just quite a feat for Ante Milicic. He's done a lot of running around trying to find the spaces, Craig, in these opening 18 minutes.
He's just playing a similar role. I saw John Aloisi the other night. He comes deep into those areas. He's coming into traffic. That straight ball right down through the heart. It's got to be hit hard. Not often it's a difficult one to control.
Here's Ortizan. Culina one. Switch was there. Bernardo towards the halfway line. Bakri. Touch for Ismaili Lessi. Firm inside. And ball looking for Culina one. Well done by Ljubo Milicevic, but it's given Indonesia their first corner of the game.
Covering by Craig Moore. There'll be no doubt working on the back four formation for each other the last couple of days.
There's not too much height from the set pieces, which is probably why they've gone low instead. Tony Vidmar's there to cover. A few Indonesian fans in the crowd. They were to nick a goal. They'll hear some noise. Pass safely shepherded behind by the Socceroos.
Certainly shown a willingness to play Indonesia at times. Certainly asking to play. No break for John McKain. 6 kilometres so far. 11% in a sprint. Expect that from a defensive midfielder. Most of the time is spent around the centre circle, just playing as the lead man. Never want him too far from the back. Central two.
Sterjovski. Offside as we pass the 20-minute mark at Subiaco Oval. Australia nil, Indonesia nil. Looks onside to me.
It's marginal. Oh, marginal. Good performance so far by Indonesia. Just they had one great opportunity. Had a couple. Certainly not overawed. Any stretch.
It's been difficult for them to focus after what's going on in our homeland this morning.
Oh, it's terrible. It really is. I said before, it's a credit to them that they can even come out and perform.
Let's just nip back down to the touchline and Andrew Sartre.
Just the notes on Peter With. Obviously, he just called over Firmin Utina to the sideline to give him instructions, but a difficult job. He's speaking through a translator, and he's also insisting that the number three, Ortizan, push on and make Brett Emerton track back. He's also looking to close the channel down this right side and to force Brett Emerton inside, which I think will open up some space for Wilkshire. So just keep an eye on that.
Will do. Thank you, Andrew. were the aforementioned Emerton Autozone challenger for the header. It's fallen for Wiltshire. Now Emerton. Shirts around him. Still Emerton. Too many men to
be. Play by Wilkshire. Lovely run around Milicic, I think it was. Good run from a midfielder. Saw the space, saw the opportunity. And he's run well. Whether he just wouldn't have been better served getting across into the box to Milicic.
Here's Hamka for Indonesia. Bernardo. Kiriman Latina. Touched by Agus Kurnia one. Player tries to dig it through for Kurnia one. Very good technically are the Indonesians.
I enjoy watching them. Very tidy on the ball.
Instead of passing triangles. Autozone waits on the left touchline. Not quite have enough weight.
Very tidy around midfield. Nice passing, first touch football, just trying to get forward into the last third, where it breaks down for them.
Well, past the midway point in the first half, second international in this Powerade series. Just a couple of chances, one for either side. Ilham early doors for Indonesia. Ljubo Milicevic. Striking a shot into the side netting for the Qantas Socceroos.
Still Lazaridis coming forward earlier, playing a ball through for Brett Emerton. Ante Milicic has his hands out. Give me the ball, he's saying. Tough roll that one up front. It's so very deep. Shouldn't like to be higher up the park. He runs forward.
Well, the Indonesians with a bit of the passing game again. Hamka. The they've not made too much progress. Now here's Wiltshire. There's John McKain into play. Vidmar. Emerton. Lazaridis wants the ball left. That's where the ball goes now. Via Ljubo Milicevic. Sterjovski comes short. Leader in support. Vidmar. Watch has made a run towards the edge of the penalty area. Four Socceroos waiting. Watch on the D. Then Indonesia have everybody, bar Kurnia one, back behind the ball. Lazaridis decides to go the direct route down to the touchline. Gets past the defender, the header by Milicic! Ante Milicic! 24 minutes gone in Perth. And Ante Milicic finds the net for the Socceroos. The credit goes to Stan Lazaridis. Got past his man, picked out his man, and Ante Milicic found the back of the net with a precise header.
Well, Stan Lazaridis, he sensed the defender was too close to him. He knew he had the pace on him, and he has whipped in a quite superb cross. Curling away from goal, you'll see here, wraps the left boot around it. Just coming back. What a lovely climb by Ante Milicic. That's his area. That's his space in the 18-yard box. That's where he wants to be. Needs service. And Stan Lazaridis, who's provided it. Beautiful header to the far post. Tucks it in the top corner. Australia have done what they set out to do. They've got in behind Indonesia. And that didn't do too often against Iraq. Good to see.
To see Ante Milicic back on the score sheet. His fourth international goal in just six international appearances. Not a bad strike rate at all. Now, Lazaridis, who set up the opening goal, is on the charge again. Quite an accurate across as a minute to go.
You can see the run from Brett Emerton. It's a good run too. Got beyond the wing back. Some space there. This is the cross from Lazaridis. How often we see him done that? Over a decade of football for the Socceroos. Loves to get in that space. More often than not, it was a very good cross as well.
A penalty to ponder for Peter Witt. He's lost his star striker, and now his team has lost a goal.
You know, it's crucial that the Indonesian team keep their shape now. Always the danger against a more experienced professional side. It starts to go wrong.
Vidmar. It's Milicic in space again. John McKain. I do like the way Ante Milicic plays that link-up role. He's playing alone in the centre. Constantly dropping short or going long, and here's another chance. Here's Culina. Milicic is short. Ball was a bit behind it. Indonesia pick up the pieces. He worked very hard, Ante Milicic, in finding space.
Absolutely. Just comes off at angles. Loves the ball into his feet. You don't often see him turning and going forward. Here's a fellow striker to do that. Likes to get the ball, get the turns. People in running off him. Ooh, a good run by Jason Celina too. Indonesia to pieces. Good ball from Stan Lazaridis. Just earlier. Emerton taken up a good position.
That's a nice little flick by Bakri. Here's Ortizan. Oh, now almost an own goal. The boot of Craig Moore, I think.
I think it was Ljubo Milicevic. He cut Craig Moore out of play. There he is. The great passages of play. On that occasion.
Good job. Zeljko Kalac was alert. It wasn't the corner too. It was Ljubo Milicevic.
Very good release. Zeljko Kalac.
Socceroos on the charge. Oh, the offside flex gone up against Joseph Culina.
And Culina is incensed. He was away. I think it was Milicic turned in the centre of the park. And he found Wilkshire, a square ball, which allowed the back, you can see here, to get back on Culina. That's why he's booted it. He knew he was away. On rare occasions, his vision of Ante Milicic down. It was a good break.
Well, we're approaching the half-hour mark, Craig. Your thoughts on the Australian performance overall so far?
Well, I think it's been good. Feeling their way into the game. Just starting to find their stride now. It's almost a slightly nervous start, really, after the performance against Iraq. I think the players' safety-first approach. Now realised they should be dominating this football match. There's no doubt there. It's important that they take that step forward now. They're 1-0 up. Surprised to see them dropping off Indonesians a lot, actually. I thought they might take the opportunity to press them high up the park and really put pressure on them.
The Qantas Socceroos only just shading possession, 52 to 48%. Sexton always telling the whole story, of course. Vidmar back to Zeljko Kalac. He's had a couple of saves to make in this game already. One off the boot of his own play. Sterjovski. Culina. Vidmar is an option. Which is inside him should he need it. Is the Bristol City midfielder. Emerton had drifted centrally. He should pick it up through Firman Utana. Culina, room to turn. Now Lazaridis. Familiar loping style, and he's ghosted through the penalty area again. Milicic waits, cut back for Emerton instead. Plenty of white shirts in the way. And McKain thumped it from a long way out. Indonesia escape. And Stan Lazaridis is in the mood to take that on. And your defence has got a problem, Craig.
Absolutely. This is Stanley Lazaridis that we know well. Once he gets a run on, he's so good at just pushing the ball into space. In loping stride. Very tough to defend.
break for Indonesia. Agus Kurniawan finds Kuman Utina. Kurniawan, the other Kurniawan was the target. Again, that's a safe hands and gets Australia going once again.
That was good football.
There's Brett Emerton. Hold off his man, that's a good challenge.
Very good.
By Hamka.
Pulled out slightly. Back in to defend Emerton there.
Tony, get it.
A lot more positive though, Australia. Trying to get past the man. Here's Wilkshire. So the whites of the goals. Run for glory.
Well worth a strike. The defence is sitting in. It's important to start taking some strikes from outside the box. Get them on target. Start to draw the midfielders out. You've got to come out and defend that. Opens up the space in front of and around Milicic.
Milicic, I think, was disappointed with Luke Wilkshire though. I thought he was in a good position.
Always disappointed strikers, aren't they? When they get the ball. Rightly so. It's a big opportunity for him, Milicic. Any time he gets to start a match for the Socceroos, he knows he has to make the most of it.
Indonesia have just gifted possession. And they at least needed to. Socceroos have their tails up here. Emerton. Finding Culina. Four men parked on the edge of the box. Here's Emerton. Ortizan for company. Awkward ball for the defence. Well dealt with. John McKain playing his club football in Romania with National Bucharest. A few Aussie guys out there, in fact, like some Wayne Schroy and Ryan Griffiths, Michael Thwaite. Just his fourth Socceroo cap tonight. His first start. No Vinnie Grella, of course, for this Powerade series. He's remained back in Italy, so a chance for John McKain to shine in that defensive midfield role.
Good chance. The Socceroo team that is possibly still up for grabs. And Simon Colosimo in the squad. I'm surprised he hasn't been given a run as well. Possibly lack of match fitness has cost him.
It's a lovely ball by Luke Wilkshire. Lazaridis sets off again. Two of them went across. They're double marketing now, Craig.
They have to. Good defending. One of the centre halves comes out. Just covers the space. In behind.
Lazaridis, right foot cross this time. Indonesia dealt with that one comfortably. And now they're on the charge. Battery. Only Kearney one to aim for, though. That is their problem when they try and play the counter. It's not always an outlet, Craig.
No, that's why they struggle. Final third, the final ball. The one up front. It's the four-man defence. Usually one on three, at least two.
Well, Peter Wythe knows that his side's problem is a lack of experience at the top level. Samsul Bakri is one of his better players. He's covered 5.9 kilometres already in this game. So he's got through plenty of work in that holding role for the visitors. Performed pretty well at Southeast Asian level. So they have to take that next step up. Find it difficult. So many defeats to the likes of Saudi Arabia and China in the last 18 months. Fantastic play. Vidmar. Wilkshire to Emerton, sold him a little short.
Hey, come on, man! Johnny, push it! Johnny, get back! Come back!
Yeah. Wilkshire's got through plenty of work today as well for the Socceroos. Cut out by Vidmar. Ortizan, and he's lost out to the Cardiff City defender. Sterjovski is the only man in the box so far. Now here's Milicic! Could have been two. possibly should have been to the Socceroos and into Milicic.
Good run by Vidmar. And Vidmar getting into space. Cut the ball back perfectly. Right onto the boot of Ante Milicic. First touch was good. Off balance. Striking with the left foot. Just starting to get some opportunities, Ante. Space starts to open up on the edge of the area.
Fermansar's ball from Ortizan. His volley has only found Milicic. Ball is coming with increasing regularity towards the Indonesia goal. Lean it to Lazaridis. Is that obstruction? Japanese referee says no. Bakri, run out of it by John McKain. Again, worth a try from long range.
Absolutely, good pressure. Pretty good defending by Indonesia. That's Lazaridis. As the ball came out, they weren't able to clear it. Still picking up the second phase.
Okay, let's go down to the touchline again. Andrew Orsati.
Peter Withe is very agitated on the sideline because he knows his players technically have some skill, but they're coming out of defence and doing it in the wrong areas, and that's what he's concerned about. They're trying to dribble out of defence, one touch too many, and they've been caught on a couple occasions now. We saw that chance for Milicic and the other one just now to McKain.
There was John McKain. He's controlled by Culina.
Trouble he has, of course. Just had very few outlets and we're sitting so deep.
Emerton. Oh, I think that was a shot. It's not even gone for a dead ball.
Something that no player likes to see. Taking a shot and going out for a throw-in. And they do win the ball in defence. Australia pushing onto the midfield. Kearney one up front. Really difficult to maintain possession.
Loss of Ilham hasn't helped, of course. Dave Moore. Vidmar. Back to his captain. Emerton. Approaching the final 5 minutes of the first half at Subiaco Oval. Ante Milicic's goal. 25 minutes, the difference between the two teams. First international in Perth, of course, since 1995. Occasion at the Wacker, Socceroos were beaten by Ghana. I think Tony Popovic survives from that starting lineup in the squad tonight. Yeah, Bakri almost confused himself. He's a busy little player. Samsul Bakri. Here's the goal again, Craig.
Beautiful header. Absolute textbook. Climbed early. Watch the back. Just directed it. Not an easy header by any stretch.
Lazaridis sets off again. Fermansar brings it out of defence. Camaro wants the ball played through midfield. Here's the number 11 and captain. Should have kept his mouth shut, shouldn't he, the captain?
One of the rare occasions I've committed players forward. And a man wide. Actually, pass went astray.
Milicic.
That's what Milicic doesn't want. Comes from defence to his head.
Kearney away. Touched by Bakri. Finds Firmant Coutinho. Has a try from an awful long way out. Here the Indonesians in the crowd, getting excited. There they are. Our coaches are enjoying the evening nevertheless, I think, at the moment.
Why not take a strike from there? You've got to back yourself and score if you don't take a strike. 30, 35 yards. A good strike to beat Zeljko and Kalac.
Peter Witt, of course, knows this area very well, has a house here. It's a good ball too, and here's Sterjovski. Great save by Hendro. That was a fantastic reflex stop by the keeper. It was a decent height for him. Sterjovski has made one or two of those runs. Another good ball by Tony Vidmar to pick him out.
Very good ball, you're right.
Beautifully measured. He's plucked it over the back of the defence. Into the chest. Sterjovski just pulled off the shoulder of the defender. Nice little run in behind on angle. He hit the volley well.
And Colina wins the header. He continues his run and he's won the ball too. Good work, Colina. This was a little too deep.
The idea was there. For the curler, into the near post. Again, it was Sterjovski.
Okay, it's a heavy challenge in Agus Kurniawan. Referee's happy for that play to continue. Emerton. It was a robust challenge from John McKain. And he's that sort of player.
That's a defensive midfield role. But that is a gorgeous ball over the top. Good control too. Well taken volley. You see here, good angle. It was, as you said, Simon, nice height for the keeper. Very close to him. Good reflexes though. Played by the Socceroos. He's really disappointed he didn't get another yard. The keeper's right.
Artisan. Firman Utina for Indonesia. Plenty back though for Australia. Artisan takes over. Well blocked by Luke Wilkshire. But for a tremendous amount of work, Luke Wilkshire. It's on sign of that midfield three. Now Milicic to Colina. Slightly overran it. Nismet. Bakri. Of passes for Firman Utina on this near side. It's more frustration for Culina with. He's even taken his cap off for a second. Into the final minutes, the end of the first half, and there will be one added minute of injury time as well. Craig Moore. Vidmar's forward again on the right. Emerton has drifted out to the left. He's got the header in as well. It's behind Sterjovski. It's by Bakri. Ball to Wiltshire. Colina. Lazaridis. Socceroos working the ball well to their advantage. Best of balls in by Laza. And Mauli Lessi. There's the problem again for Indonesia, Craig. No, that was.
That's an awful picture to see when you're a midfielder and you look up, you can't see a fellow white shirt.
Emerton. Sterjovski. Emerton was the target. Plenty of time to run up across. Sterjovski and Emerton switching flanks as Brett Emerton did against Iraq on Saturday. Never a bad idea just to keep the opposition guessing.
Something you see often now in world football. A few years ago now. You can see Figo and the like at Real Madrid swapping flanks. White guys do seem to spend a lot of time centrally though.
Chested down by Wiltshire. And the half-time whistle blows. Thoroughly satisfactory opening period for the quarter Socceroos. Ante Milicic's goal on 25 minutes is the goal that separates the two teams. That's one early scare for Frank Farina's side. Ilham, who of course has since departed through injury, forcing a good save out of Kalac. But the Socceroos, who are 10 unbeaten, are halfway to making it 11. Half-time at Subiaco Oval in Perth. Australia 1, Indonesia 0.
And welcome back to the beautiful city of Perth. You're watching Australia versus Indonesia in this Powerade series. Australia leading 1-0 at the break. Ante Milicic, the scorer in the 25th minute. Craig Foster will be with me for the analysis in just a moment. But first, the latest world news headlines with Antoninis. Is with me now to look back on the first half of this match between Australia and Indonesia. Craig, as you said in the commentary, it was a slow start by Australia, but they slowly gained confidence. I guess it's a case of eight changes and a combination that we have not tried before.
Absolutely, and you know, the team against Iraq have all said that, look, it wasn't their greatest performance. They're under some pressure to perform tonight, and I think it's always going to be a safety-first approach. You never know what Indonesia are going to offer. Although Australia always going to be far, far stronger, there's quite a gulf between the two countries in terms of football. However, in the first 10 or 15 minutes, I think the guys said, OK, let's just feel our way into the game. Frank would have said, don't bomb on forward, everyone. Johnny McKain, let's stay back four. Make sure we get into the game. Once we get ahead, and they expect to, then you expect them to really go forward now.
All right, they did get into the game a bit more, and of course they're leading 1-0. Let's have a look at these highlights.
Of course, Les, we were talking about the start from Australia. See Craig Moore very far forward here. Ljubo Milicevic, we've talked so much recently about the back four, and that was not a good start for Australia at all. Ilham it was, with a free strike on goal, having broken us down once again. Real concerns given the recent performances. And Sterjovski on that occasion outside of the box, just as Australia started to come into the match. It was a beautiful run by Ljubo Milicevic here. Great work from a central defender. Simple football coming forward. Just play off two players, a midfielder and a striker, running into space, causing problems for Indonesia. And then it was Stan Lazaridis who started to really take the game forward for Australia. In those wide areas, we do have a numerical advantage, given that they're playing a back five. We've got both fullbacks in that area. It was a beautiful ball, and it's a quite superb header from Ante Milicic. That is a quality, quality goal. You'll see him rise here, Stan Lazaridis. We know he can deliver those crosses. Look at the height he gets. Stays, hangs in the air so long. Just as the ball comes off his head, he directs it beautifully and falls to the ground. That's real quality for me. He's not had many opportunities, Milicic. I think he would have expected more playing against Indonesia, but this was a beautiful ball. It was a good run by Sterjovski. Our wide players do get in the centre of the park so very often. They do play very narrow, but Sterjovski on that occasion brought a great save out of Kartiko. It was a lovely volley.
Indeed, here are the stats, Craig, and in terms of possession, Australia 53, Indonesia 47. They are good on the ball, the Indonesians, so I'm not surprised they do have that much possession. But, of course, in the area of shots on and off target, there's a big domination.
11 shots there from Australia. Some good opportunities that we've missed. Mile Sterjovski there, foremost among them. I don't think we haven't created the sort of opportunities we'd hope to. I'm sure in the first half it's been solid, but we want more against Indonesia, and so will Frank. In the second half, he'll want more shots on target, more goals.
All right, some work rate comparison between two players, McKain and Bahri. So there you go, Craig.
6 kilometres for McKain, 7.6 for Bahri, the reason being that we've put them under a lot more pressure. He's also had more on the sprint, 22%, the Indonesian central midfielder, the reason being he's had to cover a lot more. McKain's had a very comfortable night so far. He's only 10% on the sprint. Mostly he's just staying around the correct area, covering his defenders and just helping the ball on.
7.6 kilometres, pretty good. I like Ante Milicic. Great, just a quick one. A great selection, I think, today.
I agree. It's great to see him get another opportunity. As we said before the coverage, a big night for him tonight. He needs to take every opportunity he has. Superb header. Good goal.
All right. Thanks, Craig. Let's go for a short break. When we return, it'll be the second half of Australia versus Indonesia. Stay with us.
Welcome back to Subiaco Oval in Perth. The second half just about to get underway. Australia leading Indonesia by a goal.